significance of this move in your judgment?
Well, you know, the Chinese government has always been very clear that they want to have full financial market liberalization. I think this opening up of the bond market is one of these steps that leading to the full liberalization. Be careful here. If you think about the Chinese government, they have very strong ambition to turn the Chinese currency into a global reserve currency. But if you have a very closed bond market, that ambition will not be realized. Right now, if you think about the Chinese bond markets, the foreign ownership of Chinese bond markets is about 2 to 3%, whereas if you think about the rest of Asia, the rest of Asian emerging markets, the foreign ownership of bond markets is about 40 to 50%. So it's really restricted for the foreign participation of the domestic bond market. They have to do something about it.
So play out for us, if you would, Chen, what you would anticipate would happen as a result of this. For example, let's talk about bond yields. What is likely to happen with domestic Chinese bond yields as this liberalization moves forward?
Sure. I got to make two quick points here. The first thing is don't be carried away right now, because it is a big story in news media. But this is a very limited open up, because if you read carefully, the Chinese government allows foreign capital to move in, but they are not allowing domestic capital to move out. In other words, foreign institutional investor, you can buy Chinese bonds, whatever amount you want to buy, to bring the capital into China, whereas the Chinese institutions cannot buy foreign bonds. So this is a very consistent with the Chinese way of financial liberalization, which is incrementalism. They are very careful about capital outflow. They are still very careful about capital outflow. So this is the first point you have to bear in mind. The second thing is, I do not personally think that there'll be an avalanche of foreign buying of Chinese bonds, because if you look at Asian bond yields, government bond yields in particular, they are already very compressed. The yields are very low. We're talking about Korea, for example, 2.2%, whereas the Chinese 10-year is about 3.7%. I do not think there is a loss of value. That being said, I do think that the Chinese government bonds probably offers better value than, let's say, other Asian bond market, for example, Korea. Why am I saying that? Well, think about it. The Chinese inflation right now is about 1.5%. The Korean inflation is about 2.2%, while the bond yields in Korea is about, 2%, whereas the Chinese bond yields is about 3.5%, better than 3.5%. So I do think that there is a relative value to be explored, but I don't think there is no absolute value.